Okay, we're back now with a GMA investigation about scammers possibly targeting holiday shoppers. A recent study says 40% of Americans have been victims of what's called online phishing. And that's not all you need to worry about as shopping continues to go high tech these days. ABC's Gio Benitez is here with a story. Hey, Gio.
Hey, Dan. Good morning. Adobe Analytics estimates that this year, 54% of all visits to shopping sites will come from smartphones and tablets. And that's why our warning about fake malicious apps is just so important to revisit. There are nearly 3.5 million out there at any time that hackers can use to see everything you do on your phone. So as you're about to see, the risk is very real.
We're inside a coffee shop in Washington, D.C. with a group of young people who have no idea that some of them are about to be hacked.
Here we go.
And here's why. Just this September, a massive breach made headlines.
One of the biggest outbreaks ever.
Hackers somehow introduced 50 malicious apps, also known as doppelgangers, fake apps that mirror the real thing, into the Google Play Store. Then millions of unsuspecting Android users downloaded the bad apps a total of 4.2 million times. One of those apps disguised as a seemingly simple app called Lovely Wallpaper.
And you don't realize that it's a fake.
So if you download a nasty version of Minecraft, for example, you actually seem to get Minecraft and it seems to work. But in the background, the attackers are able to access your information.
James Lyon is a cybersecurity expert at Sophos, a global security firm, and he's given Android phones to all five of our volunteers as part of our demonstration. We've told them to use the phones as they normally would. What they don't know is that James has already installed a malicious app on the phones. Now watch, with the group sitting in another part of the coffee shop.
We can retrieve their text messages.
Oh, there it is. Hey, it's me. Stunning. There's a little emoji.
Next, James triggers one of their cameras.
And he's going to have no idea that the camera's just activated. And there's a photo of one of our users.
All right, guys.
It turns out every one of our volunteers had signed in to their social media accounts.
Did anyone notice anything strange happening on your phones?
Not realizing James had stolen all of their passwords.
The person who should have noticed something going on was you.
Oh, was that? Did you take that of me while I was on my phone?
While you were on the phone.
That's terrifying.
This is the selfie cam.
That's really scary.
That was scary.
We decided to up the ante with one of the students, taking him outside. He had no idea that inside the coffee shop,
I'm tracking him now. I can see exactly where he is.
James was live streaming his camera and pinpointing his location.
He has access right now to this.
Oh no.
James can even control his text messages.
What is this? Hey, can you send me your password?
I didn't text that.
You didn't text that?
No.
But it says you did.
Yeah, I did.
And James says someone doesn't even have to be on their phone to be hacked.
Even when you weren't using the phone, we still got a picture of you.
Oh, what? How?
So the phone was just sitting there on the table, looking right up at you.
And experts say the danger is far greater than just a stolen selfie.
Once a cyber criminal's into your phone, they can access your usernames and passwords, your credit cards, basically to be able to profit from your device without you knowing.
Unbelievable, right? Well, Google tells us it has been tracking this particular malware for months, and it's constantly removing bad apps from the Play Store. It has also added to its review procedures, but the company says it really relies on the community of users and developers to catch these bad apps. And I know we've traumatized Paula. I can see it on your face.
I'm almost speechless. By the way, let me just turn your cameras down.
Oh, that's
wait,
a good
no,
trick.
No. Wait. There we go.
There we go.
Next time I send a dumb text to my wife, I'm going to say I got hacked. but let me ask you, what can we do to protect ourselves? Can you just change your password? Is that enough?
You know, that's important, but that's not enough. Because if you've been hacked, you really need to delete the app. You need to restore your phone. You need to just wipe it entirely. And you really need to look for who these developers are, research them, and make sure that you're downloading from a trusted developer.
Oh, Gio, thank you for the wake-up call. We appreciate it.
Yeah, just be a little disturbing on this Black Friday, Gio. Thanks for the warning, though.